I'm thankful that I don't have a modernist for a pastor. My pastor believed the Word of God. He believed in heaven, a literal heaven where we're going to live forever with Jesus. He believed in hell where people burn forever who reject the Lord Jesus Christ. He wasn't a Calvinist. A Calvinist believes that God preordains people to trust Christ before they're ever born. And that ain't true. Every time predestination is mentioned in the Bible, it's always connected with foreknowledge. God knew what you was going to do, and he predestinated you in Christ. So you're not predestinated until you get in Christ. They missed it. Calvin missed it. He might have knew some stuff, but he missed it. And I'm telling you, my pastor believed if you reject the Lord Jesus Christ, you go to hell forever and ever. If you receive, you go to heaven forever and ever and ever. He was not a modernist. I'm thankful tonight. And I mean this with all my heart. When I got saved, I don't know why God had mercy on me. My mom got that old-time religious spirit from Spruce Pine in the mountains. And her and my aunt Shirley sang all over Marion and different places in revival when I was little. And I felt that real thing. Then when I got saved, I went down here to the camp meeting in Nebo. And I went to the camp meeting. Brother Ed McAbee got up to preach. And Brother Ed come down. He said, the Bible said, wow. And boy, it was like everything he was saying was going down into my heart. I got to sit and listen to Lester Roloff in person. Jack Hiles, John R. Rice, Tom Malone. Maze Jackson and Billy Kelly. And them guys in person. I had Billy Kelly for a revival. Ralph Sr. and all them guys. And I remember I sat there as a young preacher. And boy, in my heart, they were talking about it. And I thought, my. It was like everything they would say. Something in me would say, that's right. That's right. That's right. You know the Holy Spirit inside you will bear witness to some truth, something you say, yep, yep. And something false comes and something says, Can't you tell it? Can't you tell it? Some old preacher say something on radio that ain't right. You can sort of just feel something just sort of, you know, you can tell. It gets off a little bit. And I'm glad I got to hear them old men preach. I'm glad I got to hear Percy Ray preach on the red lights of hell. I'm glad I got to hear Brother Sammy Allen and Dr. Phil Kidd and them men stand up and preach. I'm glad I got to hear. I'm glad my pastor, Hall Holifield, was not a modernist. He wasn't one of these that said, well, you can't take the miracles in the Bible literal, and there's no real literal hell and all that. Just quit the ministry if that's what you believe. Quit it. Do everybody a favor and quit it. I'm glad I heard about Sam Jones and George Mueller, who read the Bible through 200 times. 100 on his knees. Prayed in millions of dollars to feed them orphans. I'm glad I got to read about Wilbur Chapman and Billy Sunday. I'm glad I read about Billy Sunday, who would break chairs on the altar and wind up preaching in his t-shirt. And he run the bases. He's a professional baseball player, and he held the record for running the bases, running barefooted. They wouldn't let you do that now. He run them barefooted, and old Billy Sunday got saved and picked up a Bible and started preaching. Up there at that Pacific Garden Mission up there in Chicago, Illinois, that Unshackled program still comes on. Thank God for old bulwarks of faith like that place. Amen. You ought to thank God. You want to be thankful for something for Thanksgiving? Thank God you got hooked up with the truth and the right spirit and the right Bible and the right kind of church. Thank God we're not in some kind of cult tonight. Thank God. Thank God. Hallelujah. George Whitfield. They said you could hear that man preach on a clear night for a country mile. A mile. natural voice. And he'd preach till his throat would bleed.